Happy new week, my people. How on a day waiting they happen within this soap. Welcome back to our channel. Guys, you know what we do every Monday. So we finally met with Madam Eberi. I'm super excited about this. Guys, before we started recording, I told Madam Eberi the reason why I need to, you know, see her. And I explained everything to her, you know, the donors and stuff like that. And she started crying. And guess what? Her husband, that's the first person she mentioned. Her husband, they got married in 1994. This man was only employed for 6 years, and in 2018 the man died. Guys, let us watch this video with Madam Eberi. And by the way, because it was difficult to reach Madam Eberi, I had to get her a phone. I think I told you guys last week. Plus we also of course gave her 50,000 naira. Let's watch.
Madam Eberi, how you take find yourself in this situation?
It was 2019. My husband died November 5th. After the burial.
November when?
5th.
5th, okay.
Yeah, after the burial, December. So I'm confused. I don't know what to do again. January 2019, I started. Till today now.
How many? How many pikin you get?
Three. I finished school, but I didn't never see work. Only one person money saw work last month.
Yeah, last month. And before all this while, now you the support?
Yes. My husband is a retiree in Nepal.
Okay.
He retired was since 2000. I got married in 94.
Okay.
2000. He retired only 6 years. We are managing our life till 2018 when he gave up.
Only 6 years.
Enjoying when he was working.
Well, because of this, right, we won't support you with 50,000 naira. And I think I have a phone. Let me get the phone inside the bag. So what do you have to say to the donors?
Hey, God, I didn't even know what to say. God will continue replacing people's pockets. You will never leak, especially you, that are going to touch you. Since I be parading, nobody, I never, even all my relatives, everybody ran away.
Wow.
Nobody knows I'm alive.
Wow.
Even my colleague friend was asking, what is your husband, brother, sister doing? I say, that's so that when he alive, he have friends. But immediately he dead, he won't have friends again. Everybody ran away. I'm only with my children.
Okay.
May God bless you. But, God, I didn't even know how to thank God.
I know. I couldn't reach Madam Eberi. So, take. And this is the, make the CD, this is the 50,000 naira, so take. So make use and support your market. So what thing you go use this, like, this money do now? Because I won't make you at least buy maybe more stuff to...
If I see space safe, I will station one place. Because parading up and down is so easy.
Okay.
If you go house, all your body will pain you. And you taking medicine.
So which time you they come out in the morning and they come back?
9.
In the morning.
7.
By 7.
Night.
Wow. How old was your husband before he passed out?
60 years.
60.
Wow.
How old are you now?
I'm 55.
And you definitely still be old. Now you take care of, that still you still take care of your children.
I'm still take care of your children.
Okay, thank you, ma. That's all.
God bless.
Amen.
Hey, long life and prosperity.
Amen.
You never lack.
Amen. Okay, ma. All right. Yeah.
All right, guys, let us quickly talk about Funke Akindele. You guys know the stories, Funke Akindele and JJC, you know, they've separated. Funke Akindele, according to a source, wouldn't reply or say anything about this. I mean, I would be shocked to, reply this, like right now. Okay, she can grant an interview later, but for now, I don't think so, you know, because Funke Akindele, according to the source, you know, just want to keep mute about this and doesn't want to escalate the whole thing. But it's already escalated anyways. Guys, now, I think people need to, you know, respect JJC. Even though, you know, you're not really into entertainment, you don't really know much about entertainment and all the stories behind it or the history of Afrobeat. Like, I think it's important that you do your research about this guy, JJC. You cannot talk about Afrobeat without talking about JJC in UK. I mean, before the band, people like Don Jazzy became this huge. I mean, they were under JJC. And apart from that, I think JJC is doing well financially. I think that's another thing that's been misconstrued on social media. I mean, these are guys that are well exposed. They've been exposed all their life, even when Nigeria is still in the dark. Till now, he's got his own stuff as well. But, you know, it became bigger with Funke Akindele because it's a merger. Like, they started working together. So, yeah, it's not like the guy is going to suffer or something, but yeah. Guys, let us move straight to the next one. And here we have Toyin Abraham. Toyin Abraham continued to debunk the rumors. And what are these rumors? That herself and her husband are having issues in their marriage. And she continued to post videos, continued to write statements to show us that no, it is not true. I don't think it's necessary. You don't have to force this information down our throats. Now, let us read what our management wrote recently. They said, "We just saw a report of an untrue and alleged shaky marriage of our talent, Toyin Abraham, and our Nollywood star husband, Kola Adeyemi. Oftentimes, people say there is no smoke without fire, but this time around, we assure all fans of Toyin and Kola that there was no smoke, talk less of fire. This story is not true. Toyin has not slept out in months except for locations or when she's out of town for job. Most often than not, she and her husband are holiday together, both within and outside Nigeria. We understand that there are people who feed bloggers and just merchant lies so as to achieve selfish interest. We leave such people in the hand of God. We also acknowledge concern that people have shown regarding the marriage and prayers that God will sustain it. We thank you and appreciate the concern, but we can assure them that the marriage is intact, not shaky, and all is well." Hopefully. Yeah. I just think, right, like, first, you don't really need, some people that don't even know about this or haven't heard this report just got to know. Now, it's okay, you know, to have issues in marriage and all that. But when you have these issues, now that doesn't mean that it will lead, right, to breakup or divorce or separation. You don't need to continuously tell people that, oh, we are together, and that energy, just use it to work on your marriage, you know. That's it. Now, I really don't know whether they are, you know, they're having issues or not, but generally, I just think this is unnecessary. Let's put a break on that. We'll come back to some things that's got to do with relationship and marriage. So last week, we talked about Ed Sheeran, you know, bringing Fireboy on stage, and Burna Boy. Lil J was brought on stage by Chris Brown. I know 5 years ago, they wouldn't do this. They can do this with our top Nigerian artists, like maybe First Theory, you know, like Wizkid, Davido. Yeah, people like Chris Brown would bring them out if they had a song with them 5 years ago, like, or 6 years ago, maybe, I don't know. But these days, right, they just see all our artists as big artists. You know, only Nigerians know the levels of these artists. Like, all these American artists, UK artists, they see all of them as big artists. Like, it's like that, and which is a good thing. Let's talk about the Afro Nation. Wizkid sported In the show Benson, aka Buju, spotted there in Portugal. Like all these artists, Naira Marley, everybody link up, Mayokun, the love there is just extraordinary. Have issues with some of their performances. I think they're working on it. Our artists, especially the upcoming ones, the top guys are doing a great job. They're really working on their stage performance. They don't just play a song in background and be shouting, yeah, yeah, ah, ah. I hope we get there one day where you go to shows and you feel it, that this artist is performing the song. I mean, if I want to play a song from Spotify, I could easily just play the song or Apple Music. I can play that in the comfort of my home and just chill.
My honest opinion about Afro Nation day one. I just woke up. This is my first thought. Beautiful place, amazing energy. But my biggest criticism of this festival so far is my beautiful West African artists, the people that I saw yesterday, especially Omale, partly Rema. Why are you not singing? We came to see you live. You're a vocalist. Your main instrument is your voice. We pulled up all the way to Portugal to hear that voice live because we love what your song sounds like on recording. Now we want to hear you do it live and see the thing. As a vocalist, your main instrument is your voice. And I'm not trying to say that it's super easy to do it and that you can't have any backing at all. But honestly, if your song is playing on Spotify in the background, and you're making the audience sing, and all you're doing is saying, ja, ja! I'm not satisfied.
CDQ surprises mom in Spain. Yeah, that's amazing, though. Very beautiful. After 3 years, let's watch this video.
Anna! What the fuck? CDQ! Anna! What the fuck? Anna! What the fuck? Siddiqui, yeah, yeah.
This next news is mind-blowing. This person is a 500 level student of Federal University Otueke Bayelsa State, by the way. This guy rode his bike from Bayelsa. It took him 3 days from Bayelsa to Lagos. His name is Fajin Basi. Seriously, you know, I don't know how they were able to do it. As much as it sounds unbelievable, it actually happened because these guys got videos to show that he did this. I mean, it's also dangerous, you understand? Like, you know, you can see here, day one, he left Bayelsa 5 a.m. to 8 p.m. Yeah, that's day one. Day two, 7 a.m. to 9 p.m., 14 hours. Day three, 8 a.m. to 12 p.m., 4 hours. Total cycling time, 33 hours. This is amazing, though. I mean, just imagine the risk involved. So I think this guy deserves the recognition. Okay, back to relationship matters. You guys know what happened between Maria and Cubana chief priests, or Cubana chief priest, right? Because of Cubana chief priest's sister, you know, they believe that Maria or the guy cheated with Maria, or Maria snatched the guy from Cubana chief priest's sister. So he's got issues with her. She finally addressed that because she refused to say anything about that. Then it was trending. And here she's got this to say. And I'm going to address this once and only this once. I've been quiet on the whole husband snatcher issue. I did not ruin any home. My silence is for the best of so many people involved. That I haven't said my piece doesn't make me weak. I am respecting so many people involved and their privacy. And for the rumors of me sleeping with several married men, including a pastor, we both laughed at it because we literally breathe each other's air day in, day out, and no room for dishonesty. And so if I ever chop breakfast, I will chop it with ice cream. If it later happened for real, you will realize that ice cream is bitter then. To the next one. Guys, this is heartbreaking, you know. But let us watch it together. This man discovered that, you know, his child, well, isn't his child after some years? A child that you trained, I mean, according to him in this video, said that he actually also helped the lady while she was in school, like financially, you know, paid her school fees and all that. You can imagine the trauma this man will be going through right now. Yeah, I've seen stories like that on social media whereby some people commit suicide just because of something like this, you know. Guys, let us watch this video together.
I will not settle anything with you. After all I have done for you, you have to sleep with another man to be the child in my house.
Wow.
Women, what did I do to deserve this? I was the one that even sent you to school. I paid your school, made sure that you were exactly that you did this to me. God will punish you. God will punish you.
Well, things like this, I mean, happen. This is not going to be the first time it happens. I mean, we've seen stories whereby a man would discover that the three kids, I'm talking about three, not one or two, three of his kids are not his. Like, seriously, like, you just imagine how broken it's going to be. But guys, let me know what you think about that in the comment section below. Now, let's talk about DNA here. This person asked this question: why do women find DNA testing offensive? My own is, I don't have to distrust you to go to do DNA test. As you the bomb picking for the same hospital, the DNA test, they come out with the picking. It's not about whether I don't trust the person or whether it's just, you know, I want to sleep with my two eyes closed at night. Look, that's just me. It's not about the person. I just want, it's me. I just want to do it. Anyways, let us read reactions to that. Somebody says, it's offensive. I would rather look after the baby myself than be insulted to my face. Another person here says, because what are you implying? That I have relations with multiple people? Another person here, because you are implying that I slept with someone else. Only that is offensive. Even if it's true, hearing your partner saying it out, it's offensive. I don't see anything wrong. In fact, I think a lady that's really sure of herself should just go ahead and do it. Like, they shouldn't have issues with it. Like, why? See things from that man's perspective because of stories that he's heard or something. Okay, guys, let us move straight to the next one. This is very interesting. Yeah, let's listen to it together. This one, this lady actually chopped her breakfast. And so, yeah, let's listen to it.
You are not going to break my heart for the third time in your life, Mustafa. Can I now go? Because I swear you will never ever find any good thing in your life. I'm telling you this. If you make me swear for you, Mustafa.
Hey.
With the way I'm sick like this, I will fast and pray for you to live a horrible life. And believe me, you, God will answer me. I'm telling you, you don't have that right. You don't have these rights to come into me. What did you tell me, Mustafa? What? I deserve better.
This love is crazy. Don't say you want to see me that. So I say, anything you want, I go do. Say hello, tell me to Mumu. You know, guys.
Much as it sounds funny, it's dangerous. Yeah, you know, we look down on things like this, but you get some swear, eh? Where you see, some guys, eh, they go through something now because of swear. Some ladies don't offend some guys that they need to apologize to. This one is really bad. So this man set his ex-wife on fire. But guess what the wife did? After the man walked into the house, because they were living separately, you know, so the man is jealous, not happy, wants her to come back. And he said that the lady will not date anybody except him, even though you guys are separated, right? So he went to this lady's, you know, place where she stays and poured petrol on her in her room. And immediately he set the fire on her. The lady grabbed him. And guess what happened? They both died. The lady was the first. They were rushed to the hospital. The lady was the first, you know, to give up the ghost. And the guy followed suit. The guy died afterwards. You know, he was declared dead after, I think, a day or something. According to the information, they said this man maltreats this lady. And that's part of the reason she left him. Can you imagine somebody... People can be that violent. Like, so in case you're going through that, you better leave before you leave. You understand the leave that I'm talking about, the second one, before you leave. Yeah, so things like that happen. And here we have Yul Adochi talking about things like this, domestic violence. Yul Adochi, let's go ahead.
See, guy man not a hit woman. That's the truth. Guy man, not a hit to man. All right? Real men, they don't hit women. Correct guy, not a hit to man. You know the hit to man. You know the hit to man. Correct guy, not a hit to man. All right? Just see, no matter what, no matter how she takes vex you, if you're in a relationship with your girlfriend, your wife, no matter how she takes vex you, look, just hold yourself. Hold yourself. See, wahala day every relationship, bro. That's the truth. Forget the pictures that you see on Instagram and all those things. If people tell you the things that happen inside house, you know, with relationship with marriages, now so it be, day everywhere, you could just manage, all right? But no matter what, you do not hit a woman. You don't hit a woman, okay? You don't. They tell you, because some guys, small thing like this, some husbands or boyfriends, small thing, they don't vex. Hey, you, You, this girl, you too do. I lie. You no good. You no good. We don't approve of that one. No be correct man be that. Guy men, correct guys, they don't beat women. They know they beat. It doesn't. It's not a show of strength. Believe me, it's a show of weakness. Men, where they beat women, it shows.
Here we have a Nigerian guy that was seen, you know, spraying money everywhere, showing off on social media and stuff like that. A video surfaced online of him carrying out a ritual with a native doctor in a river. But these things are like rituals. Like, when I mean ritual, some of them include killing a human being using someone's head. It's just a glorified ritual killing. Now, I don't know, because these days a lot of things are not true. Some people just cap, you know, come on social media, do skits and stuff like that. But yeah, according to numerous reports, they said this is real, this is true. It's become normal, it's been normalized. Like, you know, money is the main thing. It doesn't matter how you get it, whether you kill someone or cut someone's head off, or you use your mother, it's not a big deal. Or you're 18 years old, 19 years old, and use someone or your girlfriend, is not a big deal. I think I stumbled on a video of a girl who accused the boy, who accused a client, because she came for hookup, right? So the guy is technically a client, who accused a client of using her pants, and she started asking for the pants because she couldn't find it. According to reports, this is not a complete video, but according to reports, she later found it and the left. Guys, here is Oba Solomon's take about, you know, Yahoo boys and stuff. Let's watch.
Do you realize that all those Yahoo boys, many of them, they are graduates? Do you realize that those of those Yahoo guys, many of them, they are professor? But because there is not a good job, you have initiated all their medulla oblongata into evil. And Yoruba dialect says, the hand that is don't do anything, Satan will find work for the hand. Or what about dilelis? You are killing our function, man, this government. This is King Solomon. I'm living at Ibeju Lekki. You're free to kill me anytime you like.
Okay, guys, moving on. For those of you that stays in Dubai, just let me know what's up, okay? What is going on in Dubai? Now, I stumbled on this video. He actually said that you have to pay for plastic bag in Dubai. So tell me, guys, how expensive it is to live in Dubai. I really would like to know, how expensive is the, you know, the life in Dubai or Arab countries? But first, let's watch Igwe Henry. That's his name.
This thing no be small thing, no. Myself, I don't tire. I think they stop for this Dubai, sir. How person will buy something with tax? Now, you want a nylon, where they will put the thing for you. You still buy nylon from the shop. I never see that. I see me now. I no use nylon cover egg when I buy this morning. Nah, pepper, I use cover egg when I buy. Which kind of thing be this safe? I don't tire.
Moving on to the next one. Here we have, former president of Nigeria, Olusegun Obasanjo, driving Keke Napep in Abeokuta. And you can see people screaming around him. Alright guys, that is where I'm going to hold it. Thank you so much for watching. And to this question, how many eggs? You can see question mark. About 95% will fail. I think so. So how many eggs? Just tell me. Do your calculations. Thank you so much guys. Until we see you next time. Peace.